Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back. Oh, don't do it. Don't. Excuse you. Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to another video. I'm gonna be covering how to use WorldAnvil as a digital series Bible. So I'm gonna cover some of the different perks of using WorldAnvil, and then I'm gonna go over this just demo style so I can show you guys exactly what it looks like. Now, if you don't know the basics about what a series Bible is or why you need one, then go make sure to watch that other video that I did, so I'll link that in the description down below. And I will eventually be covering all of the different methods of how to make a series Bible, so if you have a preference for which type of thing I cover next, make sure to drop a comment down below to let me know. All right, so let's talk WorldAnvil. WorldAnvil is a web-based world-building app that was originally designed for sort of role-playing games, but very easily applies to writing, and they've started adding features specifically for writers. I do want to cover the fact that this is a small team-created product, so if you're someone who only likes to use products that are created by large companies and you feel like there's more security in that, then this might not be the app for you. But if you're someone who likes to support small creators and likes the idea of an app created by the very types of people that use it, then this is definitely a good choice. Now, one of the really nice things about WorldAnvil is there is a free tier, and it really covers everything that you need. I am currently on the Journeyman tier, and I think Journeyman is really the max of what you would need for any standard writing project, where Master and Grandmaster are much more useful for people who are doing more RPG type things. So by doing Journeyman, you do get a bit more space. You get upgraded from 100 megabytes to 1 gigabyte, which if you're doing purely text-based stuff, doesn't really matter. 100 megabytes is more than enough, but if you wanna include a lot of photos, you're probably gonna need a little bit more space here. You do get to export your data a little more often with Journeyman, once a day versus once a week. You get 5 universes versus 2. You do get slightly less draft articles with the free version. But then the main thing that was a deciding factor for me personally was this level right here, private worlds and articles. So I wanted to start out my world being private so that it couldn't be searchable by anyone and no one else would see it but me. Another notable difference between the two is this subscribers level. So you could have a specific Patreon tier where people get to see sort of behind the scenes or secrets of your world. And I think the main other difference between the two, which sort of influences my choice, is themes and CSS personalization, so you can make your world view page look a lot nicer. You can look through this entire list yourself, but I think as a writer, you can be more than happy with this $3.99 a month, and you can definitely make the $0 a month work for you. Now, I did want to briefly mention this 5th level that it was just released, and that is Sage. It is quite a bit more pricey at $130 for 6 months, but the benefit of this is you get a custom world URL and up to 1,000 subscribers. So if you have a very large Patreon, you're a big author, this could be a really good benefit because you can give up to 1,000 people access to your secrets and behind the scenes of your world. So to keep this video a manageable length, I'm gonna be mostly just focusing on the features available to you and just highlight why this is a good option for series Bibles. This app is incredibly intuitive, so you aren't really gonna need a step-by-step guide on how to do things. So first things first, you're gonna wanna create your world, and that's just a couple quick button clicks. We'll do create a new world. You enter your title and hit create world. Now your world itself is gonna have some configuration options here, and you'll be able to change that using this menu here on the side, going down to configuration. One of the neat things about this is you'll be able to set your current date in your world and your eras. So the way I'm using this is I don't wanna set actual dates. So here I have my global era of the before Aletheia, which is essentially BC or BCE. And then I have after Aletheia, which is essentially AD or CE. And then we have settings, again, because I'm Journeyman, I have the private feature, but I could set this to public at any time and that would make this publicly searchable. This is the cover image for my world. You do have the ability to transfer your world, so if you were to ever want to give it away, that is an option. And then of course, export your world. So if you ever want to just back up your data, make sure you don't lose anything, you just hit export world. It will compile all your information into this PDF. So you can just toss this PDF in the cloud somewhere and you'll still have that data. It's obviously not gonna look as pretty as it does in WorldAnvil, but it does save everything there. So if something were to happen, you could access everything. Now, if you have Journeyman, you'll have access to this theme here where you can just set kind of a general theme for what your world will look like to the average viewer. And of course, you have access to CSS, which will allow you to do a lot of customization of the styling of how your world looks. And we'll go over that in a bit. And then you have this social section here where you can put in your Patreon and your Twitter. And so to see what all of this here does, we'll just go and view our world. And this is my world in sort of the user-friendly viewable version. So if this was public, I could send readers here and this is what they would see. So having Patreon listed and social gives me this link, click that, opens it up. And there's Josh and my Patreon. You get to be a kitten. You could be a cloud kitten and Josh could critique your work with his evil red pen. This isn't a plug, you're a plug, shh, it's okay. So yes, back to the actual video. Having your Twitter username up in that social section puts this Twitter feed in here. And here is the cover of the world. So that's what these world setting basics do. So while you're working, it's a good idea to have this world view just open in a different tab. That way, whenever you make changes, you can refresh it and see what it looks like over here. So next up, let's cover the features. First things first, we have articles. And you can either access that through here, clicking articles, or also with this little button here at the bottom. You click that and it opens up create new, and you can create new of any of these articles. And then we have this button, which is for even more quickly creating articles if you just wanna jot down an idea real quick before you forget it. Like let's say I think of an item, I just have this free form option here and my categories. So each of these things is a template, which is really great, especially if you haven't thought of these things before. This encourages you to think about them. So let's take a look at one of the most common ones, which is character. So I open that up and here we have just a ton of different options and I'm not gonna cover every single one, but this is what you're gonna be working with. It's a pre-set up template designed for character building. And you don't have to put in all of the information. If you don't, it just won't show up on your list. So here's the user-friendly version, so you can see what that looks like. Here's 736. So if you don't fill in a section, it just doesn't show up on the list because you don't want to have super small supporting characters that you put in all of these details for. But for your main character, I think it's good to try to fill out as many as possible. And one of the nice things is that you can create new articles and link them straight to this. So an example of this is conditions. 736 had Leth, but it was cured. I just clicked here, put in Leth cured and added it. So later on, I can go click articles, go to Leth cured and fill out the information for Leth. But what that does is here on her page for characters under conditions, this will now show up as a link. So if I click on that, it'll go to the page about Leth. And once I've entered in information about it, which I haven't yet, it would all show up here. And you can use that anywhere. As long as you have an article for something, all you have to do is put an @, and you can then mention that article, and it will link to it in that same way. Now we also have this design tab, which is again, CSS customization. And that's a little bit of a learning curve, but CSS is pretty easy to figure out your way around. Navigations, you can add things like tags. You can add it to categories. So I have it under the category of main characters, which means on the main page, it shows up. Under this category I created for main characters, you can assign previous articles and next articles. So there's a next and previous button at the bottom of the article so people can flip through. Then we have access. You can set it to private or open. Subscriber groups. So again, this would be if you have patrons who have special access. And then we have this tab, which is really nice, which is character relationships. And this gives you a whole little prompt you can fill out for each character relationship. So you have your character that you're on currently, and then you select a counterpart, and then you say what they are to each other. Then you have your actual opinion of that person, displayed opinion of that person, honesty towards that person, importance of the relationship, all of that sort of thing. So there's tons of options and I just really love this. Then we have this notes section. So if you ever think of a note and you don't know really where it falls, you can just add a quick note here. And it's also worth mentioning that you can do that at any time for anything. So say you have an idea and you don't know where it falls, you just go over here and you click notebook. That opens up this and you can just create notes here that you can then later categorize, or you can just leave them as notes forever. And then we have secrets, which again is that thing that only you as the owner see, or if you allow certain subscribers to see, they would see that as well. But if you have spoilers that are revealed in the actual story and you're okay with people knowing, there are also spoiler tags. So you go ahead here and click spoiler and that'll fill in these spoiler tags here. and anything you write in between these tags will show up with this show spoiler button, and that's hiding that section that we added. Now, it is important to note that this does use BBC code, which stands for, what does it stand for? Which stands for bulletin board code, which you're probably familiar with if you've ever written stuff like HTML. As you saw in this 736 down at the bottom where we have likes and dislikes, this doesn't register the extra spaces. So if I want this to register the extra spaces, I have to actually put in just a quick code for it. So they have it pre-built in here at the top, which is super convenient. You can just click the button break line, or you can just write it out yourself. But this will then be read as a separate paragraph, and now they're on separate lines. So the formatting is always going to be like that. And again, you can write it out yourself if you'd like. There is a cheat sheet that you can access on every page. You'll just scroll down here to where it says BB code reference, and it'll have this large list that tells you all of the different things you can do. It is also worth noting that you can embed Spotify music. You can also embed videos. So I went ahead and did that for a food. And I went ahead and embedded the video where I made a kind of actually good tasting version of ration blocks. For a fun alternate recipe, check out, and then I put in the video here so you can hover over it, you can subscribe. Of course you want to subscribe, why wouldn't you?
Echo has concerns.
Now since we're here, let's talk about themes. I haven't customized yet the image that's tied to this specific thing, so ignore the random rocks. But the rock image specifically is because I currently have it set to the Zen theme. But you can change this theme at any time if you're a journeyman. They have a couple presets. And then you can completely customize the theme yourself using CSS. So I currently have the CSS set to add this background image of my vines by linking to it. And if you need help figuring out the CSS, they have this nice style guide. It looks a little overwhelming if you've never dabbled in website construction, but it's really very simple. And this page here will walk you through it and makes it very easy to just copy paste the different things you need and add them to your customization. Small learning curve, but nothing you can't handle. Now, next up to talk about, we have the categories into which your different things fall. So I had my characters category under side characters. I then have super side characters for the ones that are just kind of offhandedly mentioned. So you can layer all of these into each other. And then that shows up in your world in this sidebar organization here of table of contents. And then we have maps. I haven't dabbled in maps, so I can't talk a lot about it, but basically you can do create a map, upload an image, and it'll allow you to place markers on that map, link maps together, and reference the map then from any article you create. And then we have timelines. So here I've set it up per book. When you create a new historic event, you put in the date, and then it automatically organizes the date onto this timeline. And you can put as many things on this as you'd like. So in my Alethea one, I'm eventually going to have sort of little summaries of each day as they progress. And those will also show up in your world if you choose to allow it. And that displays here in this nice, just little convenient view. Then we have images where you can just upload all of the different images of your characters and worlds. So you can then reference them and include them anywhere you need. If you're using art by someone else, this is really cool in that it lets you credit that artist. And art original URL, which is just really cool because so often artists don't get credited for their work. And this allows you to do that. We have this quick access button, which is for uploading images. Keep in mind, there are a couple little bugs here and there because this is something still in development. Again, it's a small team. Then we have secrets, which again are things that are only visible to you, the owner, and those who you have given access, who are subscribers. Then we have blocks, and this is pretty much for role player game things. So you probably won't be using this, so I'm not gonna cover it. Then we have followers. So if you have a public world, people are able to follow it, and then they will get updates when you make changes. So this is really great if you have a large world and you want to give your readers a little something to hold them over between books. And then just access rights, which is where you would create your different subscriber groups. And then one more item that I want to reference is something brand new, and that is focus mode. So let's say I create a location here. And there's so much on this page. Maybe I just really want to focus and put in a lot of details for this location. I just go over here and I click enable focus mode. And again, this isn't beta, it's brand new, so it might be a little buggy, but that opens that up here. So it gets rid of all of the extra clutter and I can focus on writing. One of the great things about using this as a series Bible is this search feature. Let's say I forgot what color Jason's eyes are. I can go and search Jason. That'll open his character thing. And I did a nice little writerly thing here. If something appears in the first book, I mark it as canon. So I have C that stands for canon. I've started actually using CA, which stands for canon Aletheia, and then the page that it shows up on. So I've been trying to include that in everything that I get straight from the book. So now let's cover some fleshed out worlds. And these are two worlds that I got permission from the managers of the world to show on here as an example of what these look like when they're fully filled out and the CSS has been played around with. So this is Ethnis, and up here we have the created by and the writer's team, and these link to each of these people's profiles. So if I click on Animal, that would then open their profile. You got all your links here. I could leave comments and feedback on their world. You can get badges. So there's definitely a community aspect to this tool. Going back to the world itself, we have all of these base details here at the top. Then we have timelines, table of contents, followers. So this is what it looks like if you have actual followers. I can click on each of these people. So let's take a look at maps since that's something I don't have. And this is an example of how you can use markers. So by adding markers to this map, you can then hover over them and you can have little details about it. And you can also have the link to the actual place. So let's look at another world that I also have permission to show on here, and that is Swordsfall. So this was created by Sulky Yoshiro. And as you can tell, this has a different design setup. So this is customized by someone else to better match this world. Now, I don't currently know how to do this fancy book cover thing, and it isn't something the average user can do. If you'd be interested in seeing a tutorial on how to do it once I figure it out, let me know in a comment down below. So let's check out the Swordsfall maps. So here's an example of this used on an actual map. And then we have these little map markers throughout. And if you hover over them, they just give a little detail. So like here we have the headquarters of Omicron Technologies. And if you click on those, they extend and you can then read a full article on them. And this particular creator has done a lot of cool things. Like here we have alert, wait, don't wander that direction. No matter what you do, don't click. Now that's something that they've done entirely in CSS. And that is something for more advanced users, but it's really neat. Now I'm gonna link both of the worlds that I referenced in the description down below so you can go check them out. And that can just kind of show you what entirely is possible with this. So yeah, as you can tell, I haven't been using this very long. I am far from an expert and I don't know what all potential issues I might hit, but so far I'm really enjoying it. I think it's a really good way to organize all of my data. And I really love the templates that prompt me to explore things a little deeper than I might otherwise. So far, I think this is a good online option, and I love that you can access it from anywhere and that you can export the data to make sure you have it backed up. And they're improving it every day and adding new features, so I think it definitely has a lot of potential. So make sure to check it out. I will link WorldAnvil in the description down below. This is not a sponsored video, so I'm not getting paid. The link is not an affiliate link. I don't get anything if you sign up. So this is purely just me trying to share with you something that has been working for me. And that was it for the video. If you found this at all helpful, make sure to give this a thumbs up and a share. It really helps the channel grow and I really appreciate it. If you like the content, you like what we do here and you want to support us, make sure to go pick up a copy of Aletheia. It is available on Amazon in hardcover, paperback, and ebook. And thank you guys so much for watching. As always, I will see you in the next video.